Welcome to Grab & Go Info. Databricks supports managed and unmanaged tables. Unmanaged tables are also called external tables. This tutorial demonstrates 5 different ways to create tables in Databricks. It covers 1. What's the difference between managed and external tables? 2. How to mount S3 bucket to Databricks and read CSV to Spark Dataframe. 3. How to create a database in Databricks. 4. How to create a managed table from a Spark Dataframe using pySpark. 5. How to create a managed table from an existing table using SQL. 6. How to create a managed table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. 7. How to create an unmanaged table from a Spark Dataframe using pySpark. 8. How to create an unmanaged table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. 9. How to delete managed and external tables. This tutorial uses Python as the default Databricks notebook language. The magic command %SQL is used when a SQL command is needed. Let's get started. In step 1, let's understand the difference between managed and external tables. For managed tables, Spark manages both the metadata and the data. Data is saved in the Spark SQL warehouse directory. User Hive, warehouse. Metadata is saved in a metastore of relational entities. The metadata and the data will be deleted after deleting the table. For external tables, Spark manages only the metadata, and the data itself is not controlled by Spark. Source data location is required to create a table. Only the metadata will be deleted. The table is saved in the external location. In step 2, we read in a CSV file from S3. To learn about how to mount an S3 bucket to Databricks, please refer to my tutorial Databricks Mount to a AWS S3 and Import Data for a complete guide. We first need to import libraries. pySpark.sql.functions has the functions for PySpark. Erlib is the package for handling URLs. Next, let's read the CSV file with AUS keys to Databricks. We specify the file type to be CSV, indicating that the file has the first row as the header and the comma as the delimiter. Then the path of the CSV file was passed in to load the file. After that, we get the access key and secret key from the Spark data frame. The secret key was encoded using erlib.parse.quote for security purposes. Safe equals space means every character in the secret key is encoded. After getting the access key and secret key, it's time to mount the S3 bucket. We can mount the bucket by passing in the S3 URL and the desired mount name to dbutils.fs.mount. It returns true if the bucket is mounted successfully. After checking the contents in the bucket using %SLS, we can see that there are 2 folders in the bucket, data and output. The folder data has the dataset we need for this tutorial. Next, let's read the dataset from the S3 bucket to the Spark data frame. We set the delimiter to be a comma. Indicate that the first row is the header, and ask Spark to infer the schema. Alternatively, we can use .csv to read CSV files. To manually define schema when reading in the data, we can use struct type to assign data types to columns. An alternative way to struct type is using a DDL formatted string. In step 3, we will create a new database in Databricks. The tables will be created and saved in the new database. Using the SQL command create database if none exists, a database called demo is created. Show databases shows all the databases in Databricks. There are 2 databases available. The database named demo is what we just created, and Databricks automatically created the database name default. The SQL command describe database shows that the database demo is saved under DBFS. User Hive, warehouse. And the owner is root. Using select current database, we can see that the current database is default. After changing the default database to demo, we can see that the current database shows demo now. To check the tables in the database, we can use the show tables in SQL command. It does not show any results because we have not created any tables yet. In step 4, we will create a managed table using pySpark. The Spark dataframe is saved as a table named demo.crypto1, and it is saved in Delta format. Using the table name without the database name demo will give us the same results because demo has been set as the default database. The best practice is to write results to a delta table. Data in delta tables is stored in Parquet format, but has an additional layer on top of it with advanced features. If you got the error message analysis exception, cannot create the managed table. The associated location already exists. It's because the table was created in the same location before. We can use spark.conf.set before creating the table to handle the error message. After creating the table, we can see that the table crypto 1 is in the database demo. The SQL code describe extended provides information about the table. It has the column name, column data type, comments, as well as detailed table information. By default, the table is saved under DBFS, user hive, warehouse, but we can change it to a different location. We can see that the type of table is managed. The type of the table can also be checked using the command spark catalog list tables. It shows that the table type is managed as well. In step 5, we will create a managed table from an existing managed table using SQL. SQL queries can be run directly on the existing tables in the database. Now the database demo has two tables, Crypto 1 and Crypto 2. The describing results show that Crypto 2 is a managed table as well. In step 6, we will create a managed table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. SQL code does not work on Spark Dataframe directly, so we need to create a view for the Dataframe and run SQL code on the view. Using the code create or replace temp view, a temp view is created for the Spark Dataframe. Next, a table named Crypto3 is created by querying the temp view. Using the magic command %SQL is equivalent to using the Spark SQL code. An alternative way is to define a table with column names and column types. Then insert the data into the table. From the output of Spark, catalog, list tables, we can see that the three tables we created so far are all managed tables. And DF is a temporary table. In step 7, we will create an unmanaged table from a Spark data frame using pySpark. The syntax is very similar to the syntax for creating a managed table. The only difference is that we specify the table location as an external folder in the S3 bucket. After the table is created, we can see that the S3 bucket has a new folder called Crypto4. In step 8, we will create an external table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. SQL code does not work on Spark Dataframe directly, so we need to create a view for the data frame and run SQL code on the view. Using the code create or replace temp view, a temp view is created for the Spark data frame. There is no need to recreate the temp view if you have created it in step 6. The only difference between creating a managed and external table using SQL is the location. When an external location is specified in the SQL code, an unmanaged table will be created. We can also use options to specify the path. If defining the column types is needed when creating the table, we can create an empty table to define column types first, then insert data into the table. In step 9, we will talk about how to delete managed and unmanaged tables in Databricks. Firstly, let's check the tables we created in the database called demo. We can see that all 5 tables are in the database. The temp view DF is also saved in the demo database. Spark.catalog.list tables shows that the tables Crypto1, Crypto2, and Crypto3 are managed tables. And the table Crypto4 and Crypto5 are external tables. Now let's run drop table to drop the tables we created. We can see that all the tables are deleted from the database. But the unmanaged tables saved on external locations such as the S3 bucket still exist. To delete the external tables from S3, we can use dbutils.fs.rm. Recurse equals true deletes a folder and the files in the folder. This tutorial demonstrates 5 different ways to create tables in Databricks. It covered what's the difference between managed and external tables, how to mount S3 bucket to Databricks and read CSV to Spark Dataframe, how to create a database in Databricks, how to create a managed table from a Spark Dataframe using PySpark, How to create a managed table from an existing table using SQL. How to create a managed table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. How to create an unmanaged table from a Spark Dataframe using pySpark. How to create an unmanaged table from a Spark Dataframe using SQL. How to delete managed and external tables. If you found the information in this tutorial helpful, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. I publish tutorials on machine learning, deep learning, and big data processing every week. If you prefer the written version of the tutorial, please go to grabandgoinfo.com. I will put the link in the video description. This is the blog post for this tutorial. It has all the code and explanations in the video. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.